Okay, then, Astronauts on track then for Scottish Championship. Carlos Grange joins on the grid. Number 11, Sean Jacklin on pole position alongside 715, Ron O'Brien. 68, Callum Thornton. He is also there in his Vauxhall Tigra. One Peugeot 206 is out there as well. I'll get that name for you in a couple of moments. H293 coming under Bosch. Another one, the Novice 206 again. I'll get the Novice car names when I have the grid sheet in front of us. But that's the first group of cars. Group number two then, headed off by, is that possibly, I think Adam Turner's going around to do the grade gaps. That's okay. So next up, we have 846 Peter McCree, just parked on the far side. So all is good there. So we're on there to about 85 Caden Morrison, the European champion, with that title a couple of weeks ago at Northampton, alongside 160 Darragh Walsh in his second meeting of the season, this one, after he made an appearance at Bovingdon. The novice car we saw earlier on was 852 of Ted McGrath, and the other one was 857 Nico Clawson. A few more cars going to join us. There's number 12, Ewan Book. But there was also 145 Scott Kinton went past us as well in the Corsa, and the other Corsa of 389, and that is Simon Lee. 447 and turn went half group 3 alongside 846 Peter McCree, aka Snoopy. Just waiting for the last few cars to come around then, so got another one to join us, another novice car on track, that's 450. Fabian, not sure on the second name on that one, unfortunately. It's gone out of my head, unfortunately. HD Benson also joining us on grid for this one. And we've got two cars at the back, 79 of Owen Potter and 36 Rapid Roy Anderson. So those are the last two qualifiers. Then 18 cars were set to take to the grid. We've got 17 out there for this race. We're missing one. Not sure who it is, though. Missing some from the back of group two. So if we can just get the grid back up, I can tell you who that is that's missing from the lineup. I think that is 966 Ryan Dilly, who is missing from the grid. He's the one that's not out there. He is a no-show for fun then. So 17 cars on track then. This will be a 30-lap race in the National World Scottish Championship. Are we going to see a third different champion? We wonder. We've already seen Kevin Mandelbosch up at the Breast in Britain title. Okay, Morris in the European title. That's been down in England, of course, at Wimbledon and Northampton, respectively. We're off and rolling then with our last race tonight, then race number 5, the 2020/21 BR National Hot Rod Championship of Scotland. So it could be nice to need to turns 3 and 4 then. The handball drop around turns 3 and 4 then. Green flag drops, away they go with the National Hot Rod. One car going sideways, and 715 Ron O'Brien, the first hit the home straight fence quite hard after a collision on turns 3 and 4 then. So 68 Callum Thornton, your early leader in the Vauxhall Tigra. His Tigra's 1-2-3 at the moment with the 206s grounding out the top 5 as 145 Kinton goes sideways down the inside of 160 Darrow Walsh. That was probably a bit of a scare for Darrow in 160 there. Simon Lee 389 looking down the inside of the 160 car. 715 Ron O'Brien harassing the back of the 85 of Morrison. His 846 Peter McCree is just giving the wall a little bit of a scrape there, so he's just met the race wall very slightly there. Might have knocked a bit of the paint off it. There's 85 Morrison still defends from 715 O'Brien. The lead back is hotting up though. 68 Thornton is defending from the 11 of Jacklin as they go into turns 1 and 2, and Jacklin down the inside and takes the lead. So the ex-Super Rod racer goes through into the race, of course making a few appearances of the slick car form. We've got Inca race. I think Thornton's got back down the inside though, going into turn 1 there. He's got a big slide behind as one of the 206 novice cars went for a half spin. And oh, on the far side there, Kinton the back of, I think that might have possibly been Nico Clawson in 857. Oh, tang on turn 4, and Darragh Walsh took the fence on his side, and oops, Randers hits him in the roof. That was unfortunate. So Roy just didn't quite get the car tight enough in the corner to avoid hitting the upturned 160 car on turns 3 and 4 that time. Now, can Walsh get that car moving again? He's going to do so, yep. Slightly delays Kinton and Turner's battle there. Turning 4 from turn, going right out towards the fence on turns 1 and 2 there is O'Brien. And Morrison still scrapping for the back. And that's for the 5th position, I believe. As the top 4 are long gone, as H293 Kevin Rush going through into 2nd place. On the inside, number 11, Sean Jacklin. Jacklin holding it around the outside there magnificently. As further back in the order, sort of car scrapping in the lower placings as Vanden Bosch looks to the inside of Jacklin again. Can he make the move stick, I wonder? I don't think so. In fact, I think I stand corrected. Commander Bush has actually gone through now in H293. He's gone past in second place, but Jacqueline is fighting back in car number 11. Off turn number two there, a bit of carnage developing there as the 160 car Dagger Walsh went into the walls. Rango's 846 piece McCree in front of us. He's spun. And he's going to rejoin as your leader comes across the timing line once again, 68 Callum Thornton. And he's in the infall there, got a tangle on turn one. Leader's gone, 293 Van Dyne Bosch also involved. Jacqueline up in the air. And, well, H293 Kevin Bosch leads the way. O'Brien is up to second place in 715. With, it looks like we've got a roller on the home straight. Not sure who that is, but hopefully they can get that car moving. They're just stuck there in the track. That's going to cause problems. It has indeed. Got cars piling in there. Rising right through the air in 36. Got clouted by Dargo Walsh in 160. And that just sent the 36 car to, to flight, really. Looking not to go over the tiles onto the football pitch. But 293, Van Den Bosch leads the way there. Coming out of turn four there. He's got a clear track in front and behind him now. He's not got any cars in the immediate future. There's 447 Turner on the back of the 85 of Morrison now. As I said, that Van Den Bosch was in clear air. He's not. He's got 846 Peter McCree in front of him. Blue flags will be waved furiously at the three cars impeding the leader at the moment. And hopefully they will let him go through. But it's going to be really frustrating here as Peter McCree is not giving way to the Best in Britain champion here. And he's making him try and go down the inside. He's done so now. And this has allowed O'Brien in 715 to catch up. But of course, that isn't going to be too difficult for O'Brien. It's not going to be too difficult for Van Den Bosch to pull away again, as O'Brien does indeed have to try and get past the back markers himself. But as it stands then, Van Den Bosch to your leader. Jacqueline is third, Kinston is fourth. We've got Turner in 54.47, his second best run of the day. Has he managed to get second place in heat number four, of course, after a DNF in his first heat, after he tangled on the far side, I think it was possibly with Simon Lee in 389, possibly. Has got a car in the inner tyres on the home show. That might be the car that rolled earlier on. I'm not sure on that, though. It probably is that car that did roll. As 11, Jacqueline needs the door open for 145. Kins come down the inside. They've got 846 Peter McCree in front of them. And hopefully they can find a way past the Vauxhall Corsa, like everyone else has so far. But McCree is really blocking these leaders here. He's not giving way very easily to anybody. And it's come to bite him in the backside. You've got a big tangle on the home straight there. It's Peter McCree, 846 goes over. He's back on his wheels. Or not, the car just flopped back onto his roof again. I'd like to know what physics was deciding with that one. But he's on the home straight, isn't he? He's able to rejoin this time. And a tangle on the far side there as the number 12 car has gone the wall backwards heavily on turn number three there. Was there contact? He didn't see. But H293, Kevin Van Den Bosch has got 715 Ronan O'Brien right under his rear wing now. And those two are really going to have a good fight for the lead in the closing laps, I would think. Third place, I think, is still 145 Kinton, possibly, as he did take Jacqueline a little bit earlier on. In fact, he is still there. Jacqueline has dropped out of the race, I think. He's dropped right back at the very least, because Turner is out to fourth place in 447 with Morrison in fifth. But Van Den Bosch now going to lap Simon Lee, number 389. First time I've seen Simon race National Hot Rod tonight, so good to see him trying something a bit different. I say he gave us some good action in the stock rods at the CP League on New Year's Day, of course. Took the final there. As they come on through, just laying the field sort themselves out there. As Dagger Walsh in 160, trying to find a way past the 36 of Ray Anderson. So Ray Anderson has some real life experience in National Hot Rods racing regularly in the Scottish series of McCown and Beath, Crimmon and Lochgelly. As tangled turn one, as 83 basically goes crashing into the fence backwards heavily. He got caught up there with the inner wall, completely identical to what happened to Callum Thornton earlier on, except the 83 car didn't lose a wheel, but it's still out of the race nonetheless. As down the far side then, Van Den Bosch in H293, still your race leader from 715 O'Brien in second place. As the last lap board now goes out, the race is coming to a conclusion. We're on lap number 30. They've got a couple of cars back marking ahead of them, but they're not going to be close enough to cause any problems. And H293, coming on Bosch, it's two titles in two title races, and he takes the title. So O'Brien second place, Turner is third. Sorry, Kinsey is third, sorry, Turner fourth, Morrison fifth, and the rest of them come through. Last couple of cars across the timing line. Okay, Mr. Please, you have them all. Red flags, thank you. On the raceway to conclude.